My goal has always been to collect as many belts and as many world titles as possible. It was all pretty sudden how it came about, me being in the Grand Prix. My dad got a phone call and they were asking if I wanted to step in as a replacement for Eddie Alvarez in the finals of the lightweight Grand Prix.
His first and only concern was about how this would affect Angela's camp, if it would logistically. We didn't want to create any additional stress or distractions, and we had a conversation with Angela. She was completely supportive of her brother being on the same event.
For me, there was no pressure in taking this match. I know that I'm the lightweight champion. There's no reason for me to step into this tournament other than just the pure desire to test myself. And that's what I've done ever since I started fighting, and that's what I'm going to continue to do.
You must respect him for his courage. There are very few athletes that are willing to step into this match at this stage with this amount of time against arguably one of the most dangerous athletes in the division, if not on the one roster.
As the champion, I believe that I should be ready to fight anyone at any time, and that's what I do. I'm training year-round, and I'm ready to face anyone that they have for me.
Short-notice fights are very unpredictable. It can work for you, it can work against you. However, the way that Christian prepares and his mindset, we feel that he will be prepared for any kind of event, any kind of challenge that's put in front of him.
This is definitely going to be a big part of my legacy, going down in history as a guy who will take any fight at any time and who's ready to face the best.
I believe Christian is just at the beginning of building his legacy, being the youngest male world champion in MMA history. Adding a Grand Prix title is another huge accomplishment. I believe his story has just begun, and there will be many interesting chapters in his story.
Christian Lee, who always makes a fast start.
Yeah, Christian comes out like a shotgun and really puts it on his opponents. Anthony's got to try to slow this down.
Oh, left hand dropped him to one knee. And that happened in England's last fight against Rocky Bartolo. Left hand also dropped him to one knee. And like he did here, he bounced straight back up again.
Christian's got good movement. He's faking that left, right kick, rather, right there. You see him pop that hip. Whoops, threatens it. Christian seems to be calming down a little bit, not quite the speed, but he's counter punching really well. It's that reach advantage that Christian Lee has.
Oh, as he spins. The speed of the spin, blistering, wasn't it? It just starts at a million miles an hour, and so far he's been able to keep up that pace in both of his fights today.
England says that he's really got to try to watch his pacing, control the speed of this fight, and try to drag this fight into the later rounds where we haven't seen Christian at all.
That's right. If England's going to win this, he needs to gradually impose himself and do something late on. That seems to be the best hope.
England tried to dive for the leg there, but ended up in a bad position. And the only thing that's really saving him here is that he's got that grip on Christian's left leg, and now he's kind of letting it go, but he bridges out of it, ends up in a scramble. Christian is such a good scrambler. He moves so well, transitioning, threatening different submissions, and now he's got the back of Anthony Anglin. Here's the elk. See how he has that one leg? This is the same thing that Angela did when she set up the first twister ever in women's MMA, and he was possibly going for it.
Kick, and then look at the movement from Christian Lee.
He's got that long jab.
very upright in his stance, does provide something of a target, but you've got to match him for speed in order to get through.
Nice, now he's starting to settle down, let some of these strikes go. So he's also switching back and forth with his stances, which is
moments of this fight, and it's just stung him once more. The halfway point in this first round, and Engelin's in a bit of trouble.
That was a beautiful switch stance, and he just came right in with that straight left hand to drop Engelin, and he's now dropping bombs.
The hammer blows, ground and pound, and Engelin's all in a mess. Gets stomped on, kick to the head, just missed with that left technical ground kick.
Big shot to the tornado, that is Christian Lee.
Forehead. Engelin gives him his back in an attempt to defend himself from this onslaught of punches.
Christian locks in the back. He's probably got the rear naked choke pretty deep.
Setting himself up for that, no question. I'm not sure it's in there yet.
Engelin's defending well, doing a good job of defense there. Christian transitions on top and into the mountain position. Engelin knows what to do here. He's got to keep moving. He's got to defend himself.
The most experienced man that Christian's met so far.
You see how Christian just flattens him out and drives his hips in. Spreading out at the Engelin. That's a lot of pressure. Good ground control by Christian Lee.
Got to be careful that the punches don't come in at the back of the head. That's what Olivier Costa's warning him about. Anything that lands between the ears to the back of the head is an illegal blow.
Very heavy on his hips. Christian Lee is showing very high level grappling. He's controlling every aspect of these exchanges. Look how he's interlacing his legs into there, applying the pressure into his hips, giving Anthony Engelin no chance to escape.
And Olivier Costa has stepped in with 48 seconds left of the opening round. Was due to the sheer barrage of punches that Christian Lee was unloading. Anthony Engelin not able to give any reply, nor indeed defend himself intelligently in the end. Christian Lee moves to 3-0.
Beautiful transition, and we can see that here's that switch, boom, and he just drops that straight left hand, which was the beginning of the end for Anthony Engelin. And once Christian got on top, the hype is real, folks. Christian Lee brings it to one championship with a tremendous pace, excellent ground control, and some really high-level striking.
His third professional win then, and there's so much more to come from this young man.
Olivier Costa holds this battle at 4 minutes 14 seconds of round number one. For your winner, via referee stoppage due to strikes, Christian Lee!
All three of Christian Lee's wins have come inside the distance. Let's see how much he's learned now. Took a little bit of time off.
I know we talk a lot about the grappling of Christian Lee here tonight, but he's also got a very underrated ground game. And I think he did learn a lot in that fight against Martin Nguyen.
Big start from one, Jian Ping.
Wan Jianping needs to make this fight ugly. He needs to get close to Christian Lee, throw big, heavy strikes, and really just not let this kid get comfortable and start to let him get relaxed and don't give him any space.
Well, you say quite rightly he's come up a couple of weights, but you can see how broad his shoulders are. This man is strong. If he unleashes a left hook to that head, he's going to do some damage. He's already shown it to us, flirted with the idea. Christian Lee has speed, though.
Wan Jianping might be coming up to weight classes, but he says that he only got this fight on 2 weeks' notice. So he's definitely conditioned himself as well because he's a lifelong martial artist. Look at him with a flurry of punches.
Well, he had to chase those punches, didn't he? Because Christian backed off very smartly indeed, and he was probably overreaching a little bit there.
Bit of a height advantage for Christian Lee.
Wan Zhongping's got to kind of punch his way upwards.
He's quite unorthodox, isn't he, Wan Zhongping, the way he throws that jab. He almost throws it and then leaps it.
But they're sneaking through the guard of Christian.
Yes,
a few
are.
Of these shots have connected flush on the chin.
Well, put together, it's a quick movement, but it doesn't seem as if it's the right way to do things. Brings that leg up to the chin, Christian Lee. A little bit of a warning shot across the bows.
Throwing heavy leather with these punches from Wan Zhongping. You know, you gotta wonder, is that part of his game plan to strike in this first round? He told me he wanted to stand and bang with the Warrior and see how good he was on that chin. And he was trying to test that chin because he thinks he sees a weakness just like Martin Nguyen did. And there's that big overhand right coming from deep into the bleachers here.
Not quite as gung-ho as he was in the early fights in his career, Christian Lee. I'm sure that fight with Nguyen has taught him a lot about just pausing for thought for a moment.
Keeping his patience, keeping his movement.
Right hand.
Staying nice and relaxed and sticking to the strategy. He's got a wide guard. I'd like to see Wan Zhongping throw some body kicks. Open that up. Look at Wan Zhongping having fun out there. Taunting Christian Lee a little bit. Connecting on some leg kicks as well.
That overhand right is going to expose him because he's falling short and he sets out his stall, doesn't he, when he does that?
But he's got to keep his guard nice and tight, keep his hands high because those kicks are coming at a serious pace.
Left and right from Christian Lee and they were quick.
Down there, got the body lock, picked Wan Zhongping up and put him down. This is where Christian Lee starts to excel, when he can branch out, space out, give himself a little bit of distance by putting that knee on the belly, and this is where those chokes start to slide in. He tries Peruvian neck ties, darce chokes, anaconda chokes from very peculiar angles. Easily steps over into side control here.
This round has breezed by, just over a minute left.
So you gotta be careful.
Fence.
Christian Lee does do some, you know, awkward arm locks. He had that chicken wing submission early in his career. It looks like there's a slight cut open
just above the left eye, yeah, and those elbows are gonna cause more damage. He's covering up Wan Zhongping.
Wan Zhongping's gotta start moving.
He's
taking a lot of those elbows. He can't take a lot of this ground and pound.
More punishment to the head. Christian Lee saw it coming, took his chance, and look at how excited he is about it.
Very pumped. Christian Lee captures another win inside the one cage. Big TKO in ground and pound. Once he was able to get on top and got this fight to the ground, he was able to put it on Wan Zhongping.
He saw that he'd hurt his opponent, didn't he? And he just jumped on it.
Just jumped all over him, Steve. Here's the short elbows, enough to open up that cut a little bit, and then he just goes to town, dropping the elbows. Wan Zhongping had enough, covered up, turned it away, and Olivier Kosh jumps in to save the day.
So, normal service has been resumed. 18-year-old Christian Lee improves to 6-1. Dominic Lau has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this fight after 4 minutes and 15 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of referee stoppage due to strikes, Christian Lee!
Christian Lee explodes out of his corner.
I like how Brooklyn waited back. He didn't rush forward. He saw he's waiting. He has that right hand chambered, though, looking for something.
It's that Chudan Suki, that reverse punch right hand down the center corridor of the solar plexus that Brooklyn throws so well. Lee's showing patience here. Boker's guard very wide. That karate stance of his.
Christian Lee came out in the southpaw stance, took a low leg kick, and immediately switched back to the right. And you can see, he says it earlier that he adjusts his stance depending on his opponent, because he reads things in those first couple minutes to where he needs to be positioned.
Jetsu Boku really does have what they call ichigeki, one punch power.
But he's got to be careful, because Christian Lee packs a good shot too, and with those hands low like that, it's going to leave his chin wide open.
Two athletes renowned for their speed. Shoots in here as Christian Lee, hoping for a takedown. Posts up on the arm, defends as Boku. Can he get up again? Lee tries to slap on a choke from behind.
This is where Lee is the most dangerous. If he scrambles, he can catch you from a lot of weird angles. Now he's got one hook in, now he's gonna try to get the other one. Good defense from Boku to screw his hips out to the side like that.
A big 10-week can for Christian Lee. Six first-round finishes for Lee coming in tonight.
Good scramble by Boku to get back up to the standing position. That was clever. He was able to avoid Christian Lee getting the hooks and get back up to his feet.
Seven first-round finishes for Kotetsu, no-face Boku. Lee presses him against the cage. Boku trying to work the right hand, looking for the undergrip now. And Lee just shrugs him off, drifts back to center cage. Boku sending that right hand again, that very deep and side on karate stance.
That was impressive, the way Boku was able to get back to his feet. He was in a dangerous position. Christian Lee was threatening the back. He was like, oh, he got front!
Here comes Christian Lee, can he take advantage now? Drills a knee to the head of Boku. The aggression from Christian Lee. Driving knees once more. Boku forced to cover up, no place to go at the moment. Gets back to his feet. And Lee drops him back down.
Oh, Darce setting up. This is with Anaconda, this is one of his chokes, he likes to go for it.
More knees to the forehead there from Christian Lee. Elbow from Lee. And he breaks off. Boku a chance to reset the veteran.
We were speaking about Boku's one-punch power, but that was a jab, I think, that did the damage.
Speed of Christian Lee prevailing on that occasion. Boku trying to force the youngster to the outside here. Testing the waters with a roundhouse kick, Christian Lee. Boku threads the jab. Lee resets. Thought about an inside thigh kick. Boku starts very side on.
The takedown, he was out from there, and the punches just finished him off. But I think he was out from the get-go off that slam. That was a beautiful takedown by the warrior, Christian Lee. Let's take a look at this again. See, that was the jab, boom, that initially dropped Boku. That hurt him, he was threatening the choke, didn't like it, chose to unleash the knees. Boku managed to get back up to his feet, but look at that, boom, belly-to-back suplex. That's what put him out. Beautiful takedown by the warrior, Christian Lee.
How about that? The teenager, Christian Lee, may have just put himself into world title contention. The featherweight strap held by Martin Nguyen of Australia.
Is a rematch in the cards there, Michael?
Seven first round finishes now for Christian Lee. How he'd love to get a tilt at the championship in 2018. A tremendous performance from the young gun. The accuracy, the timing, it was all there.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coast, has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 24 seconds in the first round. For your winner by way of referee stoppage due to strikes, Christian Lee!
Seven first-round finishes for 19-year-old sensation Christian Lee. Christian Lee, Singapore, Kazuki Tokodome, Japan.
Ready.
inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. And Christian Lee in the white trunks bounds out of his corner. A cutting side kick early to the lead knee. We're back under our global rule set, mixed martial arts. Quick hand from Christian Lee, gets a takedown.
Nice entry into that takedown. Hit that straight right hand right into a double leg. But look at the judo black belt getting thrown on his butt right there.
Ultra aggressive start here from young Christian Lee. 9 wins, 5 KOs, 4 submissions, 100% finishing rate.
Interesting clinch battle we got going on here. Tokudoma puts him down.
Nicely done there from Tokudoma. The lightweight king of Pancrase. 19 wins, 9 knockouts, 2 submissions. Second degree black belt in judo, BJJ purple belt. Holds a degree in judo therapy from the Nippon Engineering College of Hachioji.
Christian Lee's got that defensive guard right there. Now Tokudome tried to step over. Now he's in the half guard of Christian Lee. Tapping the back of the head there. That's not legal. Tokudome does a good job of pressing him up against the cage. Christian Lee's going to try to walk out and create a little space off of that cage.
Tokudome predicted he'd knock out Christian Lee with punches. Lee said, I'll submit him in the very first round. Back to their feet here. Singaporean crowd right behind Christian Lee. In his corner, his father Ken Lee, his sister, Atomweight World Champion, undefeated, unstoppable Angela Lee. Nice corking outside thigh knees there from Tokudome.
I know Martin Nguyen is paying very close attention to this one. He's in the crowd sitting front row right there. He's got his eye on both these two as possible competitors. He's gone up against Christian Lee before, and a rematch has been in the works. If Christian Lee can get past Tokudome on this one.
Side kick there from Lee. BJJ black belt, 8-week training camp. Said he refined every piece of his game, tightened up everything, says he's faster and has the advantage everywhere. Hard left roundhouse kick from Washington. Oh, right hand! Smack back on the kisser from Christian Lee.
Right into the entry, into the double leg. Tokudome's got to be careful of that trip right there. Good defense. Might give up his back. Good scramble from Tokudome.
Tokudome said his strategy is to keep the match standing for as long as he can. Though he did expect Christian Lee to try and take him down. Southpaw stance here for Tokudome. There's that right. Smack back again to the kisser. And the hammer strike from Christian Lee. The aggression now from the youngster. The reverse elbows from Lee. And he's in full mount now. Tokudome gives his back. The hooks go in. And trouble for the Japanese. Christian Lee. A house on fire. Tokudome. In one championship, the 100% finishing rate, the human highlight reel, and Martin Nguyen gives him a standing ovation.
Wow. What? Look at this. That right hand would have dropped him, but Nguyen, or Christian Lee went right into it and just absolutely swarmed all over. Tokudome gets the mount, drops the elbows, and just doesn't even go for the toe. He just punches his way from that rear. And once he has the back mount, he just starts to unload on him. Look at this, Michael, just uncorking these shots all over Tokudome. So impressive from Christian Lee.
Double cloud to enter it into the record books.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kim Cheng, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 7 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of technical knockout, Christian Lee!
Another highlight reel finish from 20-year-old Christian Lee. The warrior, indeed, an apt nickname. He brought the aggression early. He never relented until the job was done. Christian Lee. vowing to end Kelly's night inside of one round.
Ready, go!
Bounds out of his corner, does the warrior Christian Lee in the white, Kelly in the red. Inside and outside, and he kicks early from Lee. He's got the height, he's got the reach, he's got the youth.
They can't stand there. He can't allow Christian Lee to back him up against the cage. He's got to start circling. He's got to move. He's got to punch and move. Kick and move.
Tremendously long arms on Christian Lee. Kick to Lee. And clinch up for the first time.
Christian Lee's got a nasty front headlock. Snatches Kelly down. Oh, he snatches up. Look at that choke right there. Look at those long arms. Those long arms that he's losing. He's got to look at that modified guillotine. Traps the arm.
Christian Lee predicted Kelly in trouble early here. Kim Chin right on top of the action.
Kelly shouldn't roll like that. He's going to give up his mount.
Lee looking for the quick finish. Kelly no place to go. Trying to get his head out of this predicament. And now he's free. Top position though for Christian Lee. Lee's got vicious ground and power.
His top game is so heavy. His control is so good. Oh, look at that. Kelly tried to push away. Christian Lee stepped over, slid right into mount. You can see Kelly tried to push off the hips, but the hips were so heavy on Christian Lee. Just driving his hips into the body of Kelly. He can't go anywhere.
It's dominant so far from the warrior Christian Lee, only 20 years old, in full mount over his opponent, who is 14 years his elder, ferocious Edward Kelly. A six-time Pancration World Champion Lee, the Guadalajara Wushu Champion Kelly.
He's trying to create movement. He's trying to shrimp out. He's trying to trap one leg so he can create a little movement. The hips of Christian Lee are so heavy. So he's driving his hips in. Kelly can't bump. He can't create space. He's trying to go out the back door now, but that just allows Christian to posture up a little bit. He can wall walk. Can't do it. Christian Lee's hips are too heavy.
Lee on the mount for a long time now. Dropped a couple of elbows to the top of the noggin of ferocious Kelly. Control here from Christian Lee. Downward elbow again there from Lee. And another one to the ear. There's a crossing elbow on the forehead. Under the bridge of nose. The ground and pound from the 20-year-old warrior. Where does Kelly go from here, Drake?
He's trying to do it. He's trying to push down on the legs, but you can see how low Christian's legs are. So it's hard for him to create that little bit of space. But the high athletes are so explosive. But as he's explosive, he's going to turn, kick up his back, and there's going to be a choke there. But that's how gritty Kelly is. Kelly would rather stay in the mount and get smashed on than give up his back.
Christian Lee makes short work of ferocious Edward Kelly. My word, this young phenom says 2019 will be his year. He called it, Nick. He called it. He said inside of one round, no problem, I guarantee it. Put the stamp on it. I'm going to sign the pink slips, sign the ownership papers. I'm going to own Kelly. And he did.
He did just that. He did take the pink slip. Look at these hips. It was all about the hips of Christian Lee. Kelly knows how to get out of these things. He knows where he's supposed to go. He's supposed to push down on the legs, hip bump, create a little bit of space. Kelly couldn't go anywhere because of the hip control of Christian Lee. And then he just started dropping the ground and pounding.
A big hello to all of Christian Lee's fans watching live in Hawaii, USA for the first time on Bleacher Report Live. Let's go to Tom Lau, make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 53 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Christian Lee!
The prediction comes through for the prophetic Christian Lee. Ground and pound TKO inside of one round. The winner's medal goes back to Hawaii with Christian Lee. Defending champion Shinya Aoki. Ready?
Round two.
Christian Lee, the challenger, the 20-year-old phenom.
Oh, nice left hand, right hand there landed by Shinya Aoki as he jumps in for a big hook. Oh, good sprawl there by Christian Lee as he rushes forward with some hands.
Christian Lee comes in 11-3, 7 knockouts, 4 submissions, 100% finishing rate. Comes in off back-to-back first round wins of his own over Kazuki Tokodome and Edward Gallagher.
It's a 50-50 position, one hand under, one hand over the arms. Now we're gonna see Shinya Aoki start to turn. He's gonna start to create a little bit of chaos. Good job by Christian Lee. I'd like to see Christian Lee wait for Shinya to come to him, because you know what Shinya's gonna do. Shinya's gonna try to shoot him for that takedown. That's where Edward Foliang was able to catch him with that knee, is when Shinya came to him. Want to wait for him to come to it. He wanted to go to Aoki. No fear in the warrior as he was able to come forward and hurt him with the hands. And the Lees have two world champions for kids.
Shinya Aoki called out Christian Lee. Be careful what you wish for. And look at the sportsmanship. Look at the martial arts code of honor. The respect. But Christian Lee just beat down his idol. Can you believe it? Christian Lee is the lightweight champion of the world. At 20 years old, he stops the tremendous run of Shinya Aoki. That left hand was the beginning of the end. And then watch. Aoki goes down, right hand cracks him on the jaw, lines up a scooping bolo punch. Look at that right, and that left, that did the damage.
Shinya start to wilt a little bit, and then Christian jumped all over him. Shinya seemed like he wasn't quite out of it yet, but the referee thought differently as Olivier Kosh jumped in and stopped any unnecessary punishment from Christian Lee, as Angela Lee is emotionally breaking down as her brother is going to be crowned the lightweight king.
And Michael Phelps will put the belt around the waist of Christian Lee. What a moment for Christian Lee. Let's go to Tom Lau, my word.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the belt for this match, please welcome the one and only swimming legend that is Mr. Michael Phelps. Joining him, the CEO of Lou Global, Mr. Kit Wong. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Kost, has called a stop to this contest after 51 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of technical knockout and new one lightweight world champion, Christian Lee.
Amazing scenes in Singapore. The gold over the ring and the gold over the shoulder of Christian Lee. Michael Phelps presenting the belt. An amazing moment for Christian Lee, 20 years old.